to be broken.
And they said it's a 2-hour wait, so we have to wait 2 hours in this mall doing, I don't know, looking around at this new mall. So this is what this mall looks like. It's like, it's a lot bigger. There's 2 stories and there's so many stores.
Gucci purse.
Oh, those look snazzy.
Right?
And there's like so many stores that we don't know what they are. So we're gonna kind of look around. We just came out of Michael Kors and mommy got a new, it's like a handbag.
Wallet purse.
Yeah, so she'll show you guys now. It's wrapped.
Yeah.
And Michael Kors is like a handbag.
This color.
Yeah, so she got like a gold color. And so she wanted to get a new thing because she said when she goes to the beach and like amusement park, she doesn't want to carry this big black thing. I was like, if you get a new bag, I'll take your black one. And she's like, nah. So we're going downstairs. So here's what downstairs looks like. So we noticed the rich stores like up top are the most expensive stores. And when you get down here, these are like regular average stores.
Yeah.
Nice and tall.
Looks like
you'd
be in like a 3.
Choose your 2.
Gotcha.
Well, that's why. And she just got them.
I know. These are cool too, because he just made these like just for us this year.
What's the difference? Oh.
They're the same. Because one of them is like, this is like the tween and then like the youth.
Do you want to see those? No, Anna's not getting those. Is that a 3?
It is.
Scaring me, they hurt, and I'm like, there's no way.
Yeah.
They're better. They look huge.
Man, your feet grew. We're in Abercrombie. We did not know there was an Abercrombie Kids. Mommy's excited.
No, we had them before. Ours
all's closed, and we haven't been in this store forever. Okay, this store is kind of like my old store where I got my jeans. Where
yeah,
I got
you
my
did
jeans.
Get yours at Kids.
Yeah. This is my jeans. So this is where I got my jeans, and there was no Abercrombie, so like that's why I had to look for some new ones, because everything didn't have the feeling I liked in my jeans. So Ellie did get a pair of shoes from Journeys. She got these ones. She got the metallics on. We'll show you guys when she gets home, because she's going crazy because like, there's unicorn shirts and everything. So this is probably like one of my favorite Indiana stores, because we used to have one, and so this is where we would get our coats and all that. So Mark's turn. What are you looking for now, Mark? A hat? Hat. Oh, it's like his old hats. The exact same one. You never change. You're so different. Then do you have a bigger head? Let's see. Length times width is... Length times width times height is your mass. I mean your volume. I'm so smart. Oh, guys, you just can't believe I was asked to be in honors class. Okay, we're in the food court. So we are at Chick-fil-A. We'll show you guys the food court in a bit. So me and Ellie are getting Chick-fil-A because there's not really anything.
The strawberry milkshake had like strawberries in it.
Yeah.
Would I like it?
I don't know. Why, you want one? Me and Ellie got Chick-fil-A. We're by ourselves. The parents are not here.
Whatever.
So they went to Chinese. Was it actual Chinese?
Yeah.
Oh. Daddy, so what did you get?
Spicy chicken.
Mm-hmm. Mark, what did you get? Sesame chicken?
I did not.
Let's see what it looks like.
That's you got bourbon chicken.
Ew. That's weird.
Does it taste like the teriyaki?
Sesame chicken, yum.
Okay, do your arms up. Here, we're gonna buy the girls a Tesla. What do you think? Should we get it?
Yeah.
You want it, Elle?
Yeah.
Why do you want it, Emma? Because your favorite David Dobrik has one?
And Jake
Amber Taylor?
Yeah.
Ellie wants it because of the cool doors. Look, they're like bat wings.
Cup holders and a little bag. And there's two.
And then I told her, I teased her and said that there's a huge iPad and you can play Roblox on it. No. All right. We're going to have to come back.
Why? Come back?
We have to go to Apple to fix your phone.
Oh, can we come back after?
There's the car. Peep the Tesla, Mark. You want one?
Working on it.
We need one. Okay, there's your car. We'll buy it for you, Emma, for your 16th birthday.
Yeah, right.
There it is.
I think they have that one.
Nice.
Okay, we just got home from the mall. And Ellie is getting ready for bed, and so am I. I need to empty out my lunch bag, and then I'm going to go pick out my outfit for tomorrow. Actually, I'm going to do that now. So let's go do that so we can just have it ready for tomorrow, because I don't feel like picking it out in the morning. So it finally stopped raining, which is a good thing, but I'm sure it's going to rain tomorrow because Florida is like that every single day.
My room or your room, check it.
So guys, I actually wore a long sleeve today and it wasn't as bad as I thought it would be. Like, it was super cold in school, so I was like, okay, this is really nice. But I just found out pitcher day's tomorrow. I mean, not tomorrow, Friday. So I'm that. But also, I can wear shirts that go like across here. There's a girl wearing a shirt. I was like, okay, if she can't get in trouble, I can't get in trouble. Because like it doesn't work like that. If I'm gonna get in trouble, she should get in trouble for it, right? I don't really know what I'm wearing, so I'll let you guys know when I decide. I probably will change in the morning, but you just get a glimpse of what I think I'm wearing tomorrow. Okay, I have a variety of options. So this one's the first one. I wear this one a lot. This one. this one, or this black one I have. So I don't really know, so I'm just gonna like leave these down on the ground and probably try them all on and see which one like looks, I guess, like I feel more comfortable in and looks the best. So that's what my plan is tomorrow. I just got off of FaceTime with Elizabeth, and we just literally got in an argument. It's like we roast each other 24/7. It's terrible. And I just like, you started roasting me about everything. Like, oh my god, I just moved to Florida and left my best friend. And just like, it's a long story. Like, if you were my friend, I think you guys would definitely leave me in a day. But luckily, Elizabeth can keep up with me because I am so mean to her. But then she's mean back to me. So it's like, it's all good. Like, she calls me a cringy white girl. I'm just like, are you serious? So anyways, I have to get ready for bed. It is only 10 o'clock, but it does take me a long time to get ready for bed. Usually my bedtime is like 10:30, 11 o'clock. But it usually takes me about an hour to wash my face, get my room clean and everything, and do all my other stuff. Okay, so today's question of the day that we are answering is, do you believe the truth always comes out, and has the truth ever set you free? Okay, so the reason I picked this comment is because it's definitely true, and it goes to me too. Like, sometimes I do lie, but telling the truth does get you in, like, I mean, like, whatever you lie about or you tell the truth on, like, if it's something bad, it will get you a consequence, but it won't be as bad as if you lie about it and then, like, your parents find out the next day, like, you lied about it, and it just makes it worse and all that stuff. So you should, like, definitely follow this. Michaela, that was, like, a really good sentence. I mean, a really good explanation, and I really like that, so nice job.
Hi, guys, and good morning, and welcome back to another vlog. So I decided I'm going to start helping Ellie do her outfit of the day, and then she can vlog in the car, because it's hard for her to show her outfit when she's in the car. All right, so here's her outfit. I did, like, a little side twist.
So, I am going to school, and now I have my shirt. And then I have black jeans, and then my holographic Adidas. So today we have PE, and I have to go to school in like 2 minutes. So, let's go to school. And Emma will film on her way to school. So, Bye guys, hopefully you guys had or have a good day at school. Bye.
Good morning guys, from me. And I know I already wore the shirt to school. Okay, this morning it took me forever to pick out an outfit. And I already had a shirt on. It was that blue California shirt, which was a crop top. But the shorts I wore with it were high-waisted and it looked a lot better with a high-waisted. And I didn't want to wear my high-waisted jeans because like, it's too hot outside for that. So I just threw on this shirt because I was like, it's comfy, it's cute, and I mean, it's like, it's just a shirt. And I was like, okay, I'm wearing this. I don't really care if I already wore it to school. I mean, it's not like somebody's gonna remember, oh yeah, that girl wore that shirt on that day, blah, blah, blah. And yeah, so no. So we're actually getting ready to leave. I have my book bag on. I am ready. It is 9:06 and we got my lunch box packed. I packed that homemade crustable type thing. Oh, that's a really good place to put the camera. So I packed my crustables, cheese, grapes, and a granola bar. Is what I packed this morning. We're waiting on Mark and I have to put up the dog, so I'll see you guys when we get in the car.
Emma forgot to show her outfit.
So. Got these jeans on and my Birkenstocks. Not wearing anything special because, you know, at school you just gotta dress comfy.
And yeah, she wears these every day.
Okay, but at least, okay, so I've always wanted them. At least I'm wearing them, like other shoes.
What
like,
about the other shoes?
Okay, I've already wore the flip-flops twice. And then the black sandals, I wore them on the first day of school. I was actually thinking about wearing them and switching out these. But I probably will tomorrow.
The girls are at school. Mark went to go vacuum out the car. Do you ever get those days where you feel like nothing you do or nothing you accomplish is good enough? I'm having that day. And I'll just be honest, I don't know how well this vlog's gonna be today. I've just been watching the flooding, the hurricane, and you know, people coming together and helping neighbors out and people helping each other out. There was an elderly couple that needed rescued. There's an elderly guy that went and rescued a dog that a family left. Something about watching these videos and feeling the emotions is really getting to me. I feel like we're important to a lot of people and that we should do something. And I'm not talking send money or whatever because I don't think that's in my heart what I feel. I feel like we need to go there. I feel like I need to pull the girls out of school and we need to go there and make a difference. But I don't know if it's, you know, we're in the position that we can do that right now. But it makes me evaluate my family and my household and how sometimes I feel like everybody in the world deserves to be appreciated. Because everybody in this world, no matter who you are, how old you are, you add something to the world. You make a difference. And I just feel like it's not ever shown. Or maybe your parents don't ever say, you know, I appreciate you getting good grades. Because I don't know. You know, if I always say that to my kids, I think us as a family need to start. I think that we could be more supportive of each other and we could appreciate each other more. Only thing that matters is life, your breath, breathing, being alive and enjoying life and enjoying your parents and loving your parents and your sisters and your brothers and your grandma and your grandpas. That's what matters. It's just kind of made me realize that the things that you think are important are not important at all. Phones, computers, the best clothes, the best shoes, the stuff is not important. What is important to me is that I share my life with you guys and my family. I'm good about myself one day when I wake up and think I'm doing an amazing thing. I'm raising my children the best I can in the society we live in. I'm doing the best I can with my marriage. And I can't say that every day. I can't because we get so focused on phones and social media and who's friends with who and who's talking about who and all of that, that you lose focus of what is important. And I'm not doing that no more. You only get one life. You don't get to come back and do it over. Once you die. You don't get to say, oh, I would have changed that, or oh, I wouldn't have paid attention to that, or I wouldn't have cared. You get one life. I challenge you for a week to be polite, have manners, and hug your family members every day just because. Not because they got you something or they did something for you, hug them and tell them you love them. And I guarantee it will make a difference. If it doesn't, leave a comment below. But I guarantee if you, whoever's watching this, if you do it for a week and make a difference, you will feel a difference.
So we just got out of the house. We were on our way to go to a store.
Am I allowed to eat these, Mom?
Yeah, it is 7:30, and then I'm sure after Dollar Tree or Dollar General, we're going home because we got to school tomorrow. It's literally so quiet in here. Like, besides my mom, but it's literally so quiet. Like, there's nobody in here besides my family and everybody else, like, hello. So anyways, we're in Dollar General, and we about had an accident, and we would not have a vlog for tomorrow or in the rest of the days because I about dropped the camera, guys. Luckily, I caught it with this one nail. I literally grasped it with that nail. And I like grabbed it and I could literally, everybody like, and luckily I caught it. And like after it, my heart, I could feel my heart like pounding out of my chest. Like it was so bad. I was like so scared because, you know, when you drop a camera, something special and valuable to the family, you get in trouble for it. And I knew I was gonna die right after that because I'm the one that breaks the cameras. For example, number one, I tumbled into it and it was sitting on a speaker. I tumbled into the speaker and it crashed the camera, and then we had to get a new one. Number two, a screw fell out of the other one. Number three, I think that's the only things I actually did, but who knows, there could be more, I just don't even remember. But yeah, so that was a story for you guys. Too big for that. So we're in here for more containers for her organization.
You're gonna my organization.
For who?
Organizes.
For where? Our bathroom?
Yeah.
Oh. And so that's what we come here for. Dollar General always has like, ooh. Oh, those are fancy. Yeah, these are new. So look, you lift this up and it scents like the scent. That's cool. Ah. Do you need an arm to hammer your screw? Oh, man. You are extra salty today. Baby Ariel? Where? It literally just dawned on me that we're in Dollar General. Low-key though, I'm so funny. Do you need me to iron your clothes? Wait, let me press on your face.
That's my head, not my face.
Same thing. Send it, bro. You're a terrible driver.
Testing.
Oh, dang. Oh, dang. Oh, that one's just a terrible driver in general.
Watch out for the banana kidnapper.
Don't send all these, Ellie.
Go! Go!
You're picking these all up. Oh dang, honey, you hit! This is so cute. Oh, my heart is beating. Look at it, so cute. That's so cute. These are probably my favorite things ever. You know, like where their eyes pop out. So.
You're slipping.
Mommy.
I just had this mask on and I was just holding it and I went, ah! And there's Halloween masks. Halloween is literally in a month, in 2 days. Like, that is crazy. Where has time gone? Like, is that what you want to be for Halloween?
Oh, ow!
Does that hurt? What is in there?
Nothing.
Oh, then how did it hurt? See, look at this. We got a whole Halloween section. Look at all this stuff. Should I scare Ellie again?
I gave it a try. I don't know. I got her the first time, so. So excited for freaking Halloween. I'm gonna scare the heck out of you.
No, you know, just wait, Ellie, just wait. And when I was going live, my mom reorganized my bathroom and Ellie's bathroom, but I usually use it the most. But Ellie does take showers, so it's pretty much our bathroom, I guess. But yeah. So anyways, that's what we went to Dollar General for. For you guys to, I mean, not for you guys, for us to have a cleaner bathroom. So I'm gonna go show you that and explain what she did and everything else.
So here is the bathroom. So Mark, okay, so here's what we did. So we, well, what my mom did. So she added these things and then she added this little hooky thing. She cleaned the ledge up here and then Mark added new, I don't know what this, like the silicone stuff or pavement, I don't know. Then we got a new placemat, we got a toy witz. What's in here? I don't know what's in here, I didn't look in here. Oh snap, snazzy. Got that stuff. Got, that's what's inside there. This drawer's probably my favorite. It looks so cute. And like, oh my god, it looks like snazzy. That, got those. I need to take one of these hand sanitizers to school. I gotta remember about that tomorrow. Down here is we got some hair stuff. And then up here is we got all my makeup. I did go, when we got to Dollar General, my mom said that I needed some new makeup because when I put it on my face, it looks orange. And 100% agree with that. We didn't organize this. This is like all our, like this is like all the other stuff, knickknacks and all that stuff. So that is what in, that's what she did today in her bathroom. I'm super excited to take a shower tomorrow because it's actually looks really clean. I'm so excited. In my bathroom because she said that's the only time she's cleaning it. So we got to keep it clean, right? So that's what I'm going to do. So I am getting ready for bed. I probably will pick out my outfit. It is only 10 o'clock and I have 30 minutes to get ready for bed. So I am getting ready for bed. Well, we just got done watching Big Brother. My ear's a mess. And it was okay. I mean, there wasn't really anything happening. Nominations where, I mean, it's just kind of like the end of the season kind of going. Today's question of the day that we are answering is, what makes you feel complacent, something like that. I don't know what the question, what that word is. So what I like about this comment is, that's a really good way to feel achieved. Complacent means like achieved, accomplished, or when you feel accomplished or whatever. So anyways, hope you enjoyed today's video. Give this video a big thumbs up if you enjoyed it. And today's question of the day is, what gives you the most inner peace? So make sure you comment down below. Hope you enjoyed today's video and bye guys. Bye.